हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट फॉर योर टुडेस ई लर्निंग क्लासेस। टुडे आई एम योर साइंस टीचर मायसेल्फ गोपालजी श्रीवास्तव, एंड टुडे आई विल टीच क्लास 5 सब्जेक्ट साइंस, क्लास 5 subject science। today's date is 11th July 2020। okay student, in your previous classes we have already discussed about the growth of plants। student, in the previous classes growth of plants by seed, this is the method of the growth of plant by seed. It is found in the flowering plants. All flowers produce seeds and seed produce new plants, and we have also discussed about the structure of the seed and what is the different stages in the germination of the seed and what is the dispersal of seed, what is their agents. Okay student, what is their agents. Now today's my topic, next topic is topic is growth of plants with other body parts, means the growth of plants without the seed, means when plant grow with the help of other part of the plant parts, that is called vegetative propagation. Okay, in vegetative propagation plant can grow with the help of our root, our stem, our underground stem, our spores, our leaf base. Okay student, so student we will study about one by one. Okay student, from root, suppose carrot, beet, sweet potato, all these can grow with the help of roots. Carrot, beet, sweet potato can grow from their roots. And stem, example is sugarcane, rose and money plant also grow from the stem. You know student, you have already seen the structure of the sugar cane is just like, this is the nodes. When we cut the this sugar cane plant into the small pieces, a bud, this, but this is called node. This is called node. You know, student, what is the feature of stem? They are node and they are internode. Node, internode, node, internode. So, a internode are found between the two nodes. This node grow into the new plants. Okay, student. And student, some more example are given in your book. Okay, student. And the underground stem, potato, potato, ginger. You know, student, potato have some this like structure. This is called bud. Also called is eye. When it cut into the different pieces, if the pieces contain the bud generate into the plants. Okay, student. And spores, some fungi and molds. Because they are not tree, they are the microorganism. They produce with the help of their spores. When the cells body brushed, the spores generate into the new fungi and molds. And in plant can also grow with the help of leaves. From leaves, student, example, bryo, bryo, phyllum, bryophyllum. The structure of bryophyllum leaf base is just this, right? This is the margin of the leaf. When the leaf fallen down from the plant on the ground, the margin of the leaf develop a new plant. Okay, this is a bryophyllum plants. On the favorable condition, the margin of the leaves, this is the margin or leaf, leaf blade. Okay, this is the middle. This is the side plane, middle, and this is the reticulate venation. This is the petiole, and this is the tip of the leaf. Okay, so in bryophyllum plants, plant produce, plant grow from their leaf base. Okay, student. So you can write down the examples of the vegetative propagation. That is the from root, stems, underground stems, spores, and from spores, and fern also. Some more example of the spore formation, that is fern. Student, what is agriculture? So can I have this? Okay. Your next topic is agriculture. What is agriculture, student? Growing of plants. Growing of plants for the production of food and other food materials is called agriculture. Practice of growing large number of plants. इसको और भी कहते हैं practices of growing large number of plants for production of food. Okay. So you already know about stem that we have get all food materials, vegetables, fruits, medicines, and also clothes from plants and plant parts. So we are ultimately directly and indirectly depend upon the plants. So it is very, very essential for the growing of the plants, growing of the crops, growing of the fruits, vegetables, very essential for the food. You know, student, we are all need food and plants provide us food. Okay, student? So what is crop? Crop. What is crop? Student, when a same kind of the plant, when a same kind of the plant grown on a particular area in the same season, that is called crop. Suppose wheat, same kind, same field are growing same season, that is rabi crop. Rabi crop, see, wheat is the rabi crop. Okay, it is shown in the month of November and December. So, student, the getting the good and healthy crops, there are some tips for which we can get the good and healthy food. This is called steps of agriculture. Steps of agriculture. Okay. First, some tips for getting good and healthy crop. There are some tips which is very essential in the agriculture. That is the selection of seed. Okay. First, before the sowing the seed, we choose the healthy and good seed, because healthy and good seed provide good crops. Okay. Second, preparation of soil. How it will be done? This is done by the plough, P-L-O-U-G-H, ploughing or tilling. Tilling. Student, ploughing or tilling, this is done by the tractors in the modern time. And due to ploughing, the soil get loosens and provide more spaces, pores for absorbing the moisture and water. Okay, So for the loosening of the soil, ploughing is very necessary for the agriculture. Okay, student. Third, selection of seed, preparation of soil, then adding manure or fertilizer, or and fertilizer. You know, student, what is manure and what is fertilizer? Fertilizer, you know that this is the made in the industries, in the factories. This is man-made. And what is manure? It is the organic waste materials. You know how organic waste materials convert into manure? They are the excrete of the cow dungs, garbages, kitchen wastes. When they are keep in the dig and cover with the soil, after some months they convert it into humus, and which is very useful for the soil, which increase the fertility of the soil. And fertilizer, this is the artificial chemicals. Suppose urea, phosphorus, potash. Okay, this is very essential because manure and fertilizer provides nutrients to the plants. You know, student, nutrients, this is the substances which are found in the food. What is the food of plant? This is manure and fertilizers, urea, phosphorus, potash, and organic waste materials. Okay, for proper growth and development of plants, manure and fertilizer is also necessary. So don't forget when you practicing agriculture. Okay, student. And fourth, irrigation. Irrigation also necessary. Because for the germination of the plants, the some things are required, that is soil, water, warmth and sunlight. So irrigation, without water plant cannot absorb nutrients from their roots, because all nutrients are available in the soil, and water provide the passage, because all nutrients dissolve in the water and absorb by the roots of the plants. So proper growth and development, it is very necessary for irrigation. Present time irrigation is provided by the tube well. Okay, fine. Removal of unwanted weeds. Unwanted weeds means, some unwanted weeds means chrysanthemum, means pathua, chaurai, and some other grasses which are very bad for our crops, because they get the nutrients from the soil, and our main plant did not get the proper nutrients and proper growth, and so we cannot get a good and healthy crops, because a good and healthy crop provide a good yielding of the seeds, fruits, vegetables. Okay. Six, insecticide. What is insecticides? Insecticide is also a chemicals which control the plant from the pests, insects. Because they damage the crop and they eat the their leaf base stems and all green part of the plant. You know, student, when there are no leaves, plant cannot make their own food by the process of photosynthesis. So insecticide is also needed for the good production of the crops. And seventh, that is last, harvesting of crop. After maturing the crop and seed, harvesting can be done by the combine machine. Also by sickle. In villages, small farmer cut the crops with the help of sickles. And last is the storage. When we get the seed from the crops, it is very necessary for storing, because stored food, proper storage provide the good crops for the later use. Okay, student, you can write down the different stages of the agriculture. You can also read these stages in the book also. Okay, student, now your next topic is crop season. Crop seasons. But student, some farmer also live in the hilly areas. In hilly areas, the farmer getting food from the terrace farming. Terrace farming. Are found in hilly areas. In this method, farmer cut the steps of the hills, which prevent the away of soil, or away of soil, that is means the fertile soil wash away, because in the rainy season, the hilly areas, any fertile soils are pass away due to the soil erosion. So terrace farming is very, very important method for the growing of plants in the hilly areas. Student, there are two seasons are found for the in the agriculture, that is the season, crop season. First is Kharif crop. Second is the Rabi crop. It is sown in the month of April and May and harvested in September or October. Example, rice, maize, sugarcane. Okay, and Rabi crop are sown in the month of November, December and harvested in the month of April. Example is wheat, gram,
pea and beans. Okay student, so learn the other different crops by the help of your textbook. So student, this is the complete of your first chapter, plant growth. So write down the homework, read about vegetative propagation. And their examples. And second, agriculture practices. Okay, students, write down this. I hope you will learn very easily about the other ways of the plant growing from their vegetative parts, and what is the crop season, what is the agriculture, what is the stages of it. Okay, thank you. Have a good day. Okay.